Regular crystals have long intrigued but also confused scientists. They form naturally repeating perfect patterns of atoms and are sometimes described as spontaneous symmetry breaking through space. Perhaps then, when we're not so concerned with the deepest and most fundamental aspects of reality, crystals are simply nice to look at. But dedicated crystallography is also a fast-growing academic field. There is, it seems, so much we can learn from crystals, and particularly when we take them beyond the three dimensions of space and into a fourth, time. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, did scientists just create the first working link between time crystals? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content? In the modern age, physicists broadly have two totally different sets of rules for how the universe works. For any large enough object, classical mechanics will dictate how and where it can move. From paperclips to tennis balls, cars, airplanes, planets, stars, and even whole galaxies, they all adhere to the laws of motion that classical mechanics describes. And over the years, these by now familiar rules have provided us with all of the information and knowledge needed to do anything from building roller coasters to landing astronauts on the moon. But in more recent times, we've come to understand that classical mechanics doesn't really apply when we zoom in on reality very, very closely. At this, the subatomic level, it's quantum mechanics that reigns. And here, things can get quite strange quite quickly. Quantum objects can be in two states at once, for example. They can have unpredictable movements, and they can, in general, appear to defy the laws of classical mechanics completely. But where does one system end and the other begin? Merging these two sets of laws remains one of the biggest problems in physics. How quantum mechanics transforms into classical mechanics at certain sizes or points is unknown. However, there are objects which might connect these two worlds in some way, and they're called time crystals. Time crystal is the name given to the phenomenon of particles periodically recurring not just in space, but also time. Regular crystals on Earth can be called space crystals by contrast, and they're something we've all seen before. Diamonds, table salt, and even snowflakes are all examples of space crystals, which are defined by the structure of their atoms repeating in a pattern through space. While we can say that regular crystals follow the rules of classical mechanics, however, time crystals have to do with quantum mechanics. A time crystal is a system of particles that acts in harmony and repeats the same pattern or action in time as well as in space. In this way, time crystals are both stable and always changing, and so are often thought of as demonstrating a new phase of matter. To some degree, time crystals have also been labeled as a perpetual motion device, which is a problem to begin with for classical physics. Perpetual motion devices are impossible in classical mechanics because energy is always lost in some form, and so a repeated action cannot go on forever. But time crystals show that that's not the case in quantum mechanics. It's as though the symmetry of a time crystal breaks through time, creating a kind of pocket where a repeated pattern or action can exist forever with no energy required. When time crystals were first theorized in 2012 by the US physicist Frank Wilczek, they were, perhaps unsurprisingly, thought by many to be impossible structures as well. But it was only a few further years until that belief was quashed, with time crystals being built in labs from 2016 onwards. Now, though, science has moved on again. In a new experiment run this year in 2022, scientists were not only able to form two different time crystals, but they successfully linked them. Another breakthrough achievement. Now, not only do time crystals exist, and not only do we know how to produce them for ourselves, but we can also pair them up and make connections. On our way, seemingly, to building whole crystal systems. Straight away, the new findings open the possibility for future technology like fully functioning quantum computers. A multi-authored paper for the study was published in June 2022 in the journal Nature Communications, entitled "Nonlinear Two-Level Dynamics of Quantum Time Crystals." Lead researcher, Lancaster University's Samali Auti and his team used the helium isotope helium-3 to create their crystals. The helium-3 particles were cooled to the extreme and brought down to their lowest energy state, a base requirement for time crystals, at which point a sort of pulse is generated from within them, creating periodic waves of magnetic energy called magnons. It's these magnons which then fall into time crystal behavior, as their pulsing repeats, in theory endlessly, without any energy use or loss. The phenomenon goes back to a basic rule of quantum mechanics which states that objects can never be completely still. So the time crystal essentially lands into a looping pattern to infinitely produce magnon waves with no energy cost. Up until this point, the time crystals that had been made across various studies and experiments all over the world were isolated examples. It's thought, however, that the 2022 study is the first to put two of them together. With multiple crystals generated, the experimenters reportedly found that they synchronized and acted as one, despite still being two separate bodies. In one sense, all of the efficiency of a standard time crystal had now been doubled up. The researchers managed to keep their subjects paired for about 1,000 seconds in total, or almost 17 minutes, before they collapsed. In that time, the crystals had produced billions of magnons as they manifested a recurring pattern that could soon become a crucial component in our future lives. It's as though, during those 17 minutes, an energy-generating cavity had been opened up in both time and space. In the old days, we might have called it a glitch in reality, only now we're fully in control. But finally, let's return to why this research is so important, and why it's generated such excitement among those in the field. For one, again, time crystals can potentially act as a bridge between classical and quantum mechanics. Further research into them, into their abilities and properties, could allow us to better understand the relationship between these two fundamental systems of physics. Right now, there's a classical quantum disconnect, but time crystals may one day link it all together. Perhaps more imminently exciting, however, is the potential impact that this work will have on quantum computing technology. Quantum computers require something called qubits to work, or quantum bits, which are represented as neither binary 1 nor 0 like traditional bits, but can be both at the same time. Time crystals, then, could be our greatest and most logical route toward qubits. And by linking them, this latest study has hinted at how these crystals could one day form the base for ultra-efficient and powerful computing. Elsewhere, further research has also reportedly shown that time crystals can be made to function in room temperature conditions, or at least that there's a greater possibility for this in the future. In the immediate aftermath of their discovery, the future for time crystals had still seemed uncertain, largely due to an apparent requirement for ultra-low temperatures to maintain them. But in more recent times, these concerns have lessened, meaning time crystals and quantum computers are now being pitched as possible and operable in a variety of environments. In general, it's said that a quantum computer would have the computing power of billions of standard machines. And those working at the world's leading tech companies, including Google, have already shown in recent years that quantum computers can complete extremely advanced equations with seeming ease. Equations that would take a traditional computer years to work out are now being solved in seconds. But with the emergence of linked time crystals, those ridiculous speeds could soon get even quicker. It's enough to make your head spin, isn't it? We see the world in one way, but there are quantum drivers beneath it all. And between these two planes, yet more strangeness is possible. Although perpetual motion machines still can't exist in classical mechanics, it appears that they can work just fine as per quantum rules. It's why, for some, time crystals are now breaking out as the single most important scientific development of our time. They work in a new phase of matter. They've turned the previously impossible into the seemingly very possible. And they could soon revolutionize the digital and, by extension, physical world. And now they're not even working on their own in isolation. We're teaming them up together, and the results could be incredible. Because that's how scientists just created the first working link between time crystals. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.